Arrhythmias, Disturbances of AV Conduction by Christine LaGrasta.
Welcome to today's module on arrhythmias. My name is Christine LaGrasta. I work at Children's Hospital of Boston as a pediatric nurse practitioner. Disturbances of atrioventricular or AV conduction. This occurs when there is a disturbance in the conduction between the normal sinus impulse and the ventricular response. There are three main types of AV block. There's first-degree AV block, second-degree AV block, and then there are two types of second-degree AV block. They are Mobitz type 1 or Wenkebach, and then there's Mobitz type 2. And the final main type of block is third-degree or complete AV block. So first-degree AV block. The PR interval is prolonged beyond the upper limit of normal for the patient's age and heart rate. The PR interval is greater than 0.20 seconds. Sinus rhythm is maintained, and the QRS complex is normal in configuration. Causes include congenital heart disease, cardiomyopathy, rheumatic heart disease, surgical intervention, as in septal defect repairs, and digitalis toxicity. Treatment, not necessary except to address the underlying cause. Second degree AV block or Mobitz type 1 occurs when there is an intermittent failure of conduction between the atrium and ventricle. There is a progressive lengthening of the PR interval until one QRS is dropped completely. The PR interval lengthening occurs over 3 to 6 cycles until the QRS complex is dropped. All the QRS complexes are normal in configuration. Causes again include congenital heart disease, cardiomyopathy, rheumatic heart disease, myocarditis, surgical intervention such as patients with septal defect repairs, medications such as digitalis or beta blockers. Treatment includes addressing the underlying cause. If the patient is unstable, AV pacing is indicated to restore synchrony between the atria and the ventricles. Second degree AV block or Mobitz type 2. AV conduction is all or none. There's either normal AV conduction with normal PR intervals, or the conduction from the atria to the ventricles is completely blocked. Causes again include the same as the other two blocks, congenital heart disease, cardiomyopathy, rheumatic heart disease, myocarditis, surgical intervention such as patients with septal defect repairs, and medications such as digitalis or beta blockers. Treatment, again, treat the underlying cause. If the patient is unstable, AV pacing is indicated to restore synchrony between the atria and the ventricles. Third degree or complete AV block. There is AV dissociation where the atria and ventricles beat entirely independent of one another. There is no P wave before each QRS complex, or the PR interval is too short for the P wave to be associated with a QRS complex. There are more P waves than QRS complexes. Causes include cardiac surgical procedures that occur near the cardiac conduction pathway. The block can be congenital complete AV block, or from rheumatic fever, myocarditis, or cardiomyopathy. Treatment includes AV pacing to restore synchrony between the atria and the ventricles.
Please help us improve the content by providing us with some feedback.